It's Professor Dave. Let's work with rational expressions.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've learned a lot of algebra by now, and we haven't even started with all the graphing, which is a bit overdue at this point. But before we start with graphs, let's just do a little bit of bookkeeping regarding rational expressions. In algebra, we will frequently need to simplify, add, subtract, multiply, and divide these expressions. So let's make sure we have plenty of practice doing that so there's no trouble later. First, we want to be able to simplify rational expressions. To do this, we must completely factor any polynomials and get rid of any common factors in the numerator and denominator. For example, if we have x cubed plus x squared over x plus 1, we can see that in the numerator, we could factor an x squared out of each term. That would leave us with x squared times the quantity x plus 1. The reason this is important to do is that now we can cancel out both of the x plus 1 terms, leaving us with simply x squared. Let's try another one, x squared minus 1 over x squared plus 2x plus 1. In the numerator, it might not seem like we can factor this, but we have to realize that when there is a second degree polynomial with no x term, we can pretend there is 0x. This will allow us to factor like we normally do, because there are indeed factors of negative 1 that add up to 0, and those are 1 and negative 1. So this expression can be written as the product of x plus 1 and x minus 1. Then on the bottom, this can be factored to get x plus 1 quantity squared, which we can express as x plus 1 times x plus 1. We cancel out an x plus 1 from the top and bottom, and we are left with x minus 1 over x plus 1, which is as far as we can go. This kind of simplification is important because it will help us do arithmetic with these kinds of expressions. Let's say we want to multiply x plus 2 over x minus 1 times x squared plus 4x minus 5 divided by x plus 3. If we factor this trinomial, we get x minus 1 times x plus 5, allowing us to cancel out some terms, and we get this as the product. Division works very similarly. If we have x plus 3 over x minus 4 divided by x squared plus x minus 6 over x squared minus 3x minus 4, we have to realize that dividing by a fraction is the same thing as multiplying by its reciprocal. So all we have to do is flip this second fraction over and multiply. Of course, we first have to factor, so up top we get x minus 4 times x plus 1, and on the bottom we get x plus 3 times x minus 2. A number of terms will therefore cancel, and we are left with this as our answer. So multiplying and dividing are no sweat. It's actually addition and subtraction that are a little trickier, because to do this, we must have a common denominator. Say we have the following expression. We can see that the denominators are different. Well, when we first learned about adding fractions, how did we add 1/3 and 1/4 together? We had to find the least common multiple. Many times, that will just be the product of the two denominators. If we want both of these to be over 12, we just multiply 1/3 by 4 over 4, giving us 4/12, and we multiply 1/4 by 3 over 3, giving us 3/12. Then we are free to add, and we get 7/12. Here, it's exactly the same idea, just with algebraic expressions. We multiply the first fraction by the denominator of the second fraction over itself. We multiply the second fraction by the denominator of the first fraction over itself. That gives us a common denominator, and we are safe to add. Now with the numerators, we do have to FOIL both of these expressions, because that will give us a bunch of like terms that we can then combine. Once we've done that, we see that the resulting expression can't be factored, and so we just leave it like this. Subtracting works exactly the same way. We just have to make sure that when we combine the numerators, we are careful with our signs and distribute this minus sign over all the terms in the second numerator. If the denominators are more complex terms, we may have to factor them first. And once we have them factored, we can more easily see what the lowest common denominator will be. It will just be the product of all the terms in both denominators. Sometimes we will need to simplify complex rational expressions, which means there are fractions within the fraction. Here is 1 plus 1 over x divided by 1 minus 1 over x. At first glance, there doesn't seem to be much we can do, but there is if we are clever. Let's take the numerator first. How can we turn this into one term? Well, let's express 1 as 1 over 1. Now we have two fractions to add if we can get a common denominator. That will be easy. Just turn 1 over 1 into x over x. Now we can add them and get x plus 1 over x. Now let's do the same with the denominator. We get x over x and then subtract to get x minus 1 over x. Now remember, dividing by a fraction is like multiplying by the reciprocal. So let's take this whole denominator, flip it over, and bring it over here. Now we can cancel out the x's and we get x plus 1 over x minus 1, which is definitely more aesthetically pleasing than what we started with. The last thing we want to mention is that for whatever reason, we hate having radicals in the denominators of fractions. We always get rid of these when we see them. If we have something like 1 over root 2, we always multiply this fraction by the root in the denominator over itself. So, root 2 over root 2. That gives us root 2 in the numerator, and for the denominator, root 2 times root 2 is the same thing as 2 to the 1 half times 2 to the 1 half, and 1 half plus 1 half is 1, so 2 to the 1, or simply 2. So a radical expression times itself just gets rid of the radical, leaving us with root 2 over 2. If things are a little trickier and we have 1 over 1 minus root 2, then instead of simply multiplying by root 2 over root 2, we need to multiply by the conjugate of this expression, because we need to get rid of the radical. So we will multiply by 1 plus root 2 over 1 plus root 2. The numerator simply becomes this term, and then on the bottom we can FOIL this out. 1 times 1 is 1, then we get plus root 2 and minus root 2, and lastly negative root 2 times root 2, which will simply be negative 2. The reason we do this is so that the terms with radicals cancel, and we are left with 1 minus 2, or negative 1. Dividing by negative 1 is the same as multiplying by negative 1, so we can distribute the negative sign across the numerator, and we are left with negative 1 minus root 2. That covers most of the ways we will need to manipulate rational expressions. So let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.